sense of where we are, where we've been, and where we anticipate going over the course of the next week, in particular, this critical week as it relates to addressing and suppressing these wildfires here in the state of California. Foundationally and fundamentally, we're deploying every resource at our disposal, every resource that we have within the state, and you'll see in a moment some of the resources we pulled out of state into California to battle these historic wildfires. Put it in perspective, I say historic, I mean it with purpose and intention. Just consider last year at this stage, this date. Last year in 2019, we had 4,292 wildfires in the state of California, burned about 56,000 acres. 4,292 wildfires this time last year. Today, over 7,000 wildfires, 7,002 burning now, north of 1.4 million acres. 56,000 acres to date last year, over 1.4 million acres this year. We're currently battling some 625 fires across the state, and you'll see in a moment a number of new fires that appeared overnight. We've burned 1.2 million acres since just a week or so ago. Again, 1.4 million acres to date, and that's about 200,000 acres that predated these 13 plus thousand lightning strikes that we have experienced. Sadly, we've lost 7 lives so far to these latest fires, and over 1,200 reported structures. And I wanna just make point, that's the number of structures that have been reported in to our Office of Emergency Services. There's no question there are more structures that have been damaged by this historic wildfire season. Here's the last 24 hours. Close to 300 lightning strikes we experienced in the last 24 hours. As I noted, 10 new fires in the last 24 hours. So this challenge continues, including the weather today, particularly up in the Sierras, particularly in the eastern part of the state. We're still experiencing some weather, including lightning strikes, a little bit of wind. But the bottom line is these lightning strikes have been the most impactful and most challenging. It's also been impenetrable in terms of identifying fires related to these strikes. And I make the point to say there's been 10 new fires, but I want to make an additional point, and that is there are a lot of sleeper fires we expect to discover as our reconnaissance efforts, as our aerial efforts continue, particularly as the smoke begins to clear, as weather conditions change, we will be identifying likely additional fires throughout the state. But 289 lightning strikes, we anticipated a busy night last night. Good news is the lightning strikes weren't as bad as some had anticipated, but nonetheless, close to 310 new fires reported in the state. Let me give you a sense of progress as it relates to active wildfires in the state. I think it's also important to note progress, not just focus on the big challenges that we face, but also the challenges that continue to be faced here in the state. Last week, I shared with you an update of the Lake Fire, August 19th, last Wednesday. I noted that it was 38% contained. Today, it's 62% contained. So real progress being made on the Lake Fire. The Laurelton Fire last week, 35% contained. Today, 93% contained. And I make point of showing you progress because it's testament to the incredible firefighters that are out there on the front lines, the hand crews, and all of the individuals that are responsible for this effort of suppression, and the progress is demonstrable. The Holzer Fire, accordingly, 30% contained last week. You'll see now 80% contained. And the Ranch Fire got a lot of attention, 19%, now over 81% contained. So it shows what's possible, and it shows what we're doing over the course of the last 5-6 days. And I want to frame the next slides in the context of what was achieved over the course of the last number of days because of the professionalism of these frontline heroes. We now have 625 fires in the state, but 17 that we constitute major fires. And within those major fires, these are complex fires. These are the lightning complex fires that you likely have been reading about, many of you have been experiencing firsthand, the LNU up there in Lake Napa County, ZU down in the Santa Cruz area, and the SCU fire down there in the Santa Clara area. The LNU is the second largest fire so far reported in modern California history. Currently 350,000 acres in that complex, 22% contained. The CZU, 78,000 acres. What is remarkable at the CZU, and I was down there again yesterday, is this is a coastal fire, primarily along the coast near the Santa Cruz Mountains, in forests, a lot of redwoods that have simply never seen forest fires because of the weather conditions and the like. Again, a proof point that we are in a different climate and we are dealing with different climate conditions that are precipitating in fires, likes of which we haven't seen in modern recorded history, in dense forests that are well covered and have been historically immune from significant fires along our coast, though 13% contained, not where we need to be. I just want folks to know down in the Santa Cruz area, I made this point after visiting a number of shelters down there, meeting with folks who were evacuated. We are getting more personnel on that fire, have over the course of the last 48 hours, in particular the last 24 hours, more engines, more dozers, more aerial equipment in and around that area. The SCU fire is now the third largest fire in California's history, while the LNU is 350,000 acres as of this morning. The SCU is 347,000 acres as of this morning. We are also battling fires that persist. August fire and the Carmel fire and the Sheep fire, you'll see the containment there, 11, 15, and 0%. The Sheep fire is about 26,000 active acres as we speak. Carmel, about 6,700 acres active. August fire is primarily a grass fire, larger, 178,000 acres, primarily though a grass fire, 11% contained, but one that we constitute as a major fire that we are currently battling. We secured over the weekend a presidential disaster declaration, had to be approved by the president himself. I want to thank the president for his support of that disaster declaration. We had anticipated he would be supportive, and indeed he was supported. That declaration included some flexibility on including additional counties in the state. One of those counties that was included in the last 24 hours is Monterey County. I want to thank Congressman Panetta and others for their advocacy and their stewardship and support of that effort. Now,